Greetings, friends. Sonictoast here. It has been a long time since I've made a video. You know, I used to be making multiple videos a week, and now I'm lucky if I can get one in every 2 or 3 weeks. And it's because I have a lot of very personal stuff going on in my life right now, going through a lot of struggles of which I don't feel like making public right now. But if I could be making lots more videos, I would. But I'm just not in a place right now where I'm able to. I hope you can forgive me for that, but I'm gonna try to stay on top of things as is, okay? So, sorry about that. I just wanted to throw out the little disclaimer in case you've been wondering where I am. I'm alive. I'm alive and well enough, considering all things going on right now. But, toasters. We have a lot to do, and so I'm probably just gonna be making shorter videos, so I'll be able to get them out there, instead of long videos, which will take me forever and ever to make. But I've got a lot to cover, a lot of World Nintendo stuff. It's been so long. I have all this stuff in the boxes that we still need to unbox. So yeah, let's see, we're on series 2-4 of World Nintendo. So let's get through some of it today. Toast. All right, friends, so series 2-4 contains a new variant of Mario. We'll go over that in a bit. Yoshi repaint, which is a blue Yoshi, a Inkling boy, which is quite exciting. This is like the one unique figure in this entire set. There is a new variant of Toon Link, which is interesting. And the one I have not found yet is that new Samus, the Phazon suit, however you say it. So that one I have not found. However, apparently part of Series 2-4 is also this Samus, which is the gold one, which took a lot of Walmart searching to find. And I hate these gold ones. I also found this Mario, which is part of series 2-3. So are they gonna make a gold one as part of every series now? Cause it's ridiculous. And then I also have collected these ones of Fox McCloud and Toon Link as prototype variants. I mean, they're just black and white, you know, lacking in color, which I find super annoying. I mean, like, these guys weren't even on Game Boy. If they did it of, like, Mario and, like, Donkey Kong, you know, characters that were pretty prominent on the Game Boy, I'd love to have black and white versions of them, but I find these to be really stupid variants, and, so yeah, that's kind of annoying. And looking at them, Link is series 2-3 and Fox is series 2-2, so there's probably a 2-4 prototype variant out there. I don't know for sure. I hope they don't make any more of these. I like the gold ones better than the prototype ones, but overall, I don't like any of them. We'll unbox these when it comes time to it. And yeah, they're made just for the sake of being collector's items, stay in the package. I don't care. I think that's dumb. An action figure should be made to be an action figure, which should, you know, be posed and set up and played with and put on a shelf. So, yeah, toasters. What are we going to do today? Let's start with, you know what? Let's go with the Inkling Squid, or Inkling Boy, and Yoshi. These two in today's unboxing. Okie dokie. He's the one that's most exciting because he's the first time in this scale. It's the first time in these, you know, 4-inch scale figures we've had a Splatoon character. So that's great to have another IP as part of World Nintendo. I'm totally down with this. Like, Splatoon, it was a good game. I got Splatoon, I played through it. It was a good game, not my favorite. Like, I'm not gonna become a super Splatoon fan. But I did like it, and I like it more than Animal Crossing, so I hope they do more Splatoon World Nintendo stuff and less Animal Crossing. So, he's got his ink gun here. I wish they did the girl. They should make the girl definitely. World Nintendo makes, like, almost no female characters. There's, like, all the Samus variants, there's Zelda and Sheik, and there's Peach, and, like, that's it. Like, the boys outnumber the girls, like, 10 to 1. Anyway, so he's pretty... a typical action figure. It's got a turning head, ball joint elbows, yes. And ooh, good elbows, good bending elbows, twisting elbows. I meant ball joint shoulders the first time I said elbows. Ball joint shoulders, great twisting elbows, lots of articulation in there. Twisting hands, bending wrists, nope, just twisting. And then legs, are they ball joint? Yep, ball joint legs, and let's see, got ball joint knees, twisting feet, yep, twisting feet. So yeah, it's pretty good for an action figure. And what about his tank on the back? Does that come off? It doesn't feel like it comes off. I don't want to break it in case it doesn't come off, but it does have a little bit of movement there, so that's pretty nifty. All right, stay fresh. All right, cool. Now, Yoshi! Yoshi's a character they could just repaint forever, right? When are we gonna get orange Yoshi and white Yoshi figures? So yeah, this is what, the fourth Yoshi in the series? Fifth? Fourth? I don't know, I gotta check now. Okay, so the Past World Nintendo Yoshis are pink, red, and green. And so now we have a blue one. So that makes four whole Yoshis. I'm betting yellow is next on the list. That'd be awesome. But I'd also love black, white, orange, purple. Yeah, I'd love to see lots of colored Yoshis because, like, right now it's just on par with the Popco, you know, Banpresto Yoshis they did for that set of Mario figures. You know, they did green, blue, red, pink, and yellow. So if we get yellow, they'll be equal. But if this set makes, like, black, purple, orange, white, all those other Yoshi colors that we don't see quite as often, that would just be fantastic. So we definitely want to see that. So that has been the first unboxing of series, what is this, 2-4. So tune in next time as we'll be doing Mario and Toon Link. All right, bye.